How strange to have a little lamb Sunday without all the kids and teachers in the service. Maybe we can have them sing for us after we are free to worship in person once again. Parenting and rearing kids isn't easy. Our mission for our children is to help them to be successful. Every parent, grandparent, child worker wants them to grow up to be successful. Now, to be sure, we have to define what we really mean when we say successful. Success cannot be defined by the world at large as having temporal, financial, materialistic success. That's what many of the voices we hear and that our kids hear is focused on. The world's view of success is wrong and damaging to a person. For those who are followers of Jesus Christ and believe the Holy Scriptures, the voice of God tells us that success means to be circumspect, intelligent, skillful, wise, and sensible. The word success isn't used often in Scripture, but it is used about Joseph, Joshua, David, and Solomon. Solomon advises us in Proverbs chapter 3, verse 1 and verse 4, "My son, do not forget my teaching, but let your heart keep my commandments, so you will find favor and good success in the sight of God and man." How do we help our children of any age pursue success as defined by the Bible? I think it is this: create an environment in which our children can grow in favor with God and with people. I think we see that in Solomon's advice in Proverbs 3, but we also see it in Luke chapter 2, verse 52, where we are told that Jesus increased in favor with God and man. We need to provide every opportunity for our children to develop character and godliness, to learn how to relate to God and the people around them. We need to help them develop the abilities, talents, and strengths given to them by God. We need to model and teach them how to be givers and bless others, not just to look out for themselves. To create an environment that helps our children be successful, we need to have healthy families. We need to love our children, and we need to limit and question the voices that speak into their lives. I want to challenge you to think about the six voices that speak into the lives of our children. Take time to list them in order of reality. What voices are the strongest in our world today? Then list them according to what is ideal, to what it really should be. Then ask how we can work to influence each of the voices for good. How can we help each other to create an environment conducive for our children to grow up to be successful? I hope you can have some good interaction at home and online. And I would ask that you let us know what you came up with. It might help someone else.